Hi, this is your host, Jeff Ragavan, and you're listening to Marketing Mix, where we hear from some of the most influential CMOs of today to discuss the strategies of tomorrow. Welcome to Marketing Mix. Joining me today is Christi Lazar. Christi is the Senior Marketing Manager at Nestle Waters North America. Christi, it's awesome to have you on the show.
Thank you so much for having me, Jeff. I'm thrilled to be here.
Absolutely. So, Christi, we do a ton of work together. So, fortunately, I get to talk to you and see you all the time. But, you know, I wanted to bring you on the show just because you're doing so many amazing things at Nestle Waters. And obviously, for everybody listening in, Nestle Waters is a massive umbrella of many brands. And, you know, there's so much that goes into what you do in the day-to-day life of Christi. So maybe we could just quickly start off and, you know, tell us a little bit about your role and everything that you do for Nestle Waters North America.
Absolutely. I mean, the day-to-day life of Christi is a little scary, but generally, I lead personalization and content lab across all of our brands at Nestle Waters North America. And I'm so lucky to work on iconic brands like San Pellegrino, Perrier, Aquapana, and Poland Spring, just to name a few. Now, you might be wondering, personalization, content lab, what does that have to do with each other? But the thing is, it has a lot to do. They're related quite a bit, because in order to really fuel personalization across the entire consumer journey, you need content. So I lead our internal content studio to fuel that.
From a content perspective, right? You know, the brands themselves are they're very different, right? You have different personalities and, you know, different consumers are buying the product. So how do you tackle so many different brands with so many different personality?
Yeah, I think it all comes down to consumer insights. If you have good consumer insights for your brand, then it's easy to pick a few passion points. Now, I'm saying that, and I'm also talking about 12 brands at the same time. So it does become a bit of a monumental task, but it also comes down to like good consumer journey mapping and understanding where your content's coming from. So what content is coming from an agency that's developing maybe your TV content or your paid content, and then what's coming from agencies and partners like Social Native, and where we can best fit influencer and creator content into the journey, and then what do we build internally across all of the brands, what can be fed dynamically, et cetera. And then it doesn't seem so daunting, because you realize that you can speak to your consumers in a one-to-one way based on their primary affinities and utilize the amazing partners that we have, agencies and internal, to create a cohesive journey.
Awesome. You know, what I find amazing about you, Christi, is not only are you managing like all of these, you know, brands from a content perspective, but you have some very deep insight that most people don't have when they're kind of tackling this from a business perspective. So you have a wildly successful social media blog. You're a kind of a big deal. You're an influencer in the food space. So, you know, that's something that I find truly amazing, because you actually know what consumers want to engage with and what they react with. And so talk to us a little bit about your kind of outside of Nestle and how that impacts your role at Nestle and all of the cool stuff that you're doing.
Yeah, I got to talk about that side hustle, Bazaar Lazar. And, you know, it started almost 4 years ago now, just as a creative outlet. I was living in LA working for startups. I wanted to start eating healthier. And I was just like, you know, I'm in digital marketing and it would be really fun to walk the talk. And I was like, okay, I have a kitchen that's definitely circa 1970. Two of my four burners actually work. And in order to bake something in my oven, I have to rotate it every 15 minutes. But why not? Let me start cooking. And I never imagined anyone would like what I was doing, let alone over 30,000 people. So it's a humble hustle, right? A humble hustle.
Now, I follow you, and I have to say that every single day, you are literally pushing out like mouth-watering, delicious dinners and lunches. And I'm a foodie myself. So I was like, damn, That's really beautiful. Like you just posted a couple of days ago this incredible Chilean sea bass that had the perfect sear, the perfect, you know, golden brown crust.
Mm-hmm. Yep. I love that. It was so good.
I'm trying to get people every day, like asking you for, you know, tips and help on how to cook and all of that stuff. Like, I'm sure it's daunting. Like, how do you keep up with it?
It is daunting, especially since it is the side hustle, and Nestle Waters North America and personalization and content are my main hustle. But it's about engaging, and it's about really understanding what my audience what resonates with my audience, but also connecting with them. And this all goes back to personalization, right? Like, it's connecting with them on a one-to-one basis. And if they're asking for tips and I have enough people asking for it, I'll do a demo. Like over the weekend, I did a how to poach your eggs Insta story series, and now it's on the highlights. My audience was saying like, hey, your eggs look beautiful, but how do I do it? So it's just listening to your audience, which is the same as listening to your consumer, and seeing what they want, and then creating content that speaks to you, because it's always so important to stay authentic and true to yourself and your core and your message and your ethos, but also giving your audience what they're looking for.
Let's kind of ping pong back to Nestle Waters. So let's talk a little bit about personalization, right? One, how are you guys tackling that? And two, how do you figure this out, right? So from a data perspective and from an ongoing interaction perspective, like how are you pushing out the right type of content to the right people?
At the end of the day, there's like a very simple answer to this question. It's almost too simple, but good personalization is only as good as the data signals that you have and the technology you have in place to execute it efficiently, right? Like it's so simple. But how do you get to good personalization and good data signals? And that's kind of what at Nestle Waters North America, we've been working very hard on, which is from the upper funnel through the lower funnel. It's looking at the entire consumer journey from awareness through purchase and loyalty and repurchase, and how we can find out the data signals that people will be giving us, bucket them appropriately, make sure we have content to support it, which comes from journey mapping. And then that's what I was speaking about earlier, where we have, you know, our agency content from social native, content we create internally, where and how that plugs in. And then using that data that you then get at the end of the journey, or as the consumer is going through the journey, to make your media smarter and make sure you're targeting the right people. Make sure the affinities that you were hypothesizing at the beginning of your journey, like, for example, Christi loves food and she loves fashion and she loves architecture. Sure. And that was at the beginning of the journey. But maybe in the middle of the journey, you're like, oh, she actually doesn't love fashion. She just likes onesies. So like, how, you know, letting your data throughout the journey inform the content you're creating to speak to the consumer in a one-to-one way, but then use that to become smarter at our media and smarter with our marketing and more personalized and intentional.
Sure. You know, Christi, we've been working together now for a couple of years, and you often refer to social native as almost like your content farm. Mm-hmm. So for those folks that are listening in, you know, can you talk a little bit about that, but how do you leverage social native as part of your overall strategy?
So I think something that I really loved about working with you and social native is the authenticity of the content that's created. And as brands, we always want to stay authentic to who our consumer is, as well as what our brand represents.
Everyone talks about, we want our content to be authentic. Like, what does authenticity mean?
Authenticity is a delicate balance. It's a very fine line, because there are two sides to authenticity, right? There's the brand side of authenticity, which is making sure that as a brand, I don't appear too stiff or too rigid, and I'm really staying true to my core belief and my core insight. And then on the other hand, you have the people creating the content and what's authentic to them. So it's a very fine line. And I think that's going back to how we've worked with Social Native, that's been the beauty of our partnership, because you have been able to help us bridge that gap between brand authenticity and staying true to our guidelines, but then also making sure that the creators who are developing this amazing content for us feel good about what they're creating and posting and sharing to their audiences. As an influencer, that empathy is so important to me, because I come from the creator side, but I also come from the brand side. And as we're building briefs and as we're partnering together, if it's one or the other, it's not going to feel truly authentic and integrated. So it's making sure that when you approach a brief and you're saying, hey, creators, we need this amazing content for Perrier, and it's got to be cocktail focused and fantastic. Okay, cool. But for the creator, what does a fantastic cocktail mean to me? And how can I make that work within your brand guidelines? And that's really where Social Native has come in and really helped bridge that gap and make sure we're getting the content that speaks to both parties.
That's awesome. I think that is definitely something that, you know, you hear every day, whether you're a technology company, whether you're a brand, whether you're an agency, you know, in this new era of, you know, personalization around content, everyone says we want it to be authentic, but no one really has a specific definition like you've just described.
Right? I have a really funny story, actually. When I first started, when I was brought on to lead the partnership between Nestle Waters North America and Social Native, I was looking at an old brief from, I think, the very early days, and one of our team members had said, like, I just want this content to feel premium. And that was it. That was the brief. I mean, not the whole brief, but the gist of the brief. I mean, it was a pretty slim brief. And we were looking at the content that we got, and that simple definition without like real structure gave us premium content that was premium in so many different ways to so many different creators, right? Like, what is premium to you isn't premium to me, isn't premium to the brand. Like, it's such a vague definition. So when we speak about authenticity and we speak about, you know, the creator and the brand, it's about having a mutual understanding of whatever your objective is to make sure that everyone's on the same page and you're really clear about what you are trying to convey to your audience. So the creator then knows how to take their vision of premium and make it work for your brand.
By the way, how many pieces of content have you guys created?
It has to be something like over 1,000, I think, at this point. It's so much content.
Yeah, that's a lot of content. So if you could think back, and this might be a very difficult question to answer, but, you know, do you have a favorite campaign or favorite piece of content or, you know, anything that really stuck out to you like, wow, this is awesome?
So I have two answers to this question. And it's not actually a hard question to think about because it's very easy. Perrier Stop Motion Holiday. Creative. So,
love those.
So good. It's so good. And it's thumb stopping, right? Like, we were talking earlier about the food that I create and how it's like delicious. But the thing is, like, if you're going to post something, you need to make room in such a cluttered space that it has to be thumb stopping. It has to be effective in grabbing your consumer's attention, your audience's attention. And I think with stop motion and with just changing up the type of content you're posting, whether it's still video, stop motion, boomerang, cinemagraph, whatever you want to do, making sure you have that variety of content that keeps your consumer engaged. And I think the stop motion content was just a first for Perrier and performed so well and really resonated with the audience and was something very different for us.
I specifically remember that campaign over the holidays, and even today I'm like, wow, those were great.
Now, my second answer to the question is the work. It's for us, we have 6 different regional brands that span the country. And if I paid an agency or if I went and traveled to all of these different regions of the country, it would be very hard for me to create authentic regionally based content that would resonate with my consumers. So the work that Social Native did with our regional brands last year for sparkling was absolutely incredible, so authentic to the different regions, and really cohesive in its messaging and so fun, you know, just really good content.
Great. Not only, you know, do you have this incredible experience of, you know, being an influencer yourself, but also managing so many different brands and so many different styles and so many different creatives. Is there anything that you could maybe talk about for those folks that are listening in who are, you know, this is really focused on the marketing community, as everyone's starting to really focus more and more on content and creative through consumers? Is there any type of top tips with working with content creators that you could maybe give to folks who are listening in now?
Absolutely. So it's one, understand your consumer journey and really know where your content is needed. And then really understand what kind of content you need for that area in the journey. And what I mean here is awareness content is going to be very different than your lower funnel purchase content that you see on like Amazon or Walmart or things like that. So just understanding where your content plays throughout the journey. And then as you're working with your creators, really brief them well. I cannot get through this enough, but like really, really, really brief them well and give them guidelines. Give them what your brand guidelines are. Give them what you're actually looking for. Don't make them guess. Like, let them understand what you're looking for so that they can be truly creative in their space.
So Christi, the show is called Marketing Mix for a reason, right? We bring on folks to not only talk about marketing and technology and all that fun stuff, but we also mix it up with some personal questions.
I'm ready. Let's go.
All right. So let's just say that you are stranded on an island. It's a desert island. If you had to pick one meal, one book, and one song to take with you, what would they be and why?
All right. It's very interesting. I'm going to do the book first because I feel like that's the easiest. And it's one of my favorite books. It's Me Talk Pretty One Day by David Sedaris. It's the first book that ever made me laugh out loud on a plane. Mm-hmm. Like, legitimately, the person next to me was, like, I think a little concerned when I was halfway through the book. And they were just like, what? So I know that book would always entertain me forever and ever. For the song, so I'm one of those people that plays a song on repeat until I legitimately can never listen to it again. So I'm trying to think of what song I would...
Same.
I think it might be like Andrea Bocelli's Time to Say Goodbye. I can rock out to that song like every day, all day. Or Celine Dion. Anything Celine Dion. There's something in there. And then for a meal, that's I think the hardest part of this question. If I'm on a desert island and I'm assuming there's water around me, so then I could figure out fishing. So I'd probably bring like seared steak. Mm-hmm. Probably bring seared steak. I actually posted that last night on my Instagram, but I would bring beautifully seared steak because I probably wouldn't be eating meat again for the rest of my life.
And if you had a superpower, what would it be and why?
I think I would have flight. I think I would really want flight so that I could go anywhere super quickly. Hopefully it's flight where I can leave the atmosphere and go to other planets and explore galaxies and, you know, Superman-esque.
Amazing. I would choose the same thing. Okay, so, and finally, before we head out, if you were really to think about this, is there, you know, and this could be an easy question or a tough question, but, you know, what's the same mistake that you will make over and over again?
Oh, of course, everyone always makes a mistake over and over again, right? Like, that's just who we are as humans. I always try and go above and beyond in everything I do, whether it's work or personal or friendship or family. And I think sometimes I blur the line over and over again between, you know, that whole self-care and giving to others. And I think that's something a lot of people struggle with, especially like, you know, we talk about work-life balance. We talk about just making sure that you're taking time for yourself. So I think that's something that I always forget about and I need to focus on more. But I think taking a step back from whatever it is you're doing in your life and just taking a deep breath and taking a moment for you is really important.
Awesome. It's been great to, you know, dig in a little bit to you personally and, you know, hear some of all of the cool things that you're doing and the last meals that you'd eat. And, you know, really appreciate you coming on the show.
Thank you so much for having me. I am so excited that I got to like share a little bit.
Awesome, Christi. Thanks again.
Thank you.